Hey, once again, good morning. The topic for this morning session is about the modern period of corrections or the modern day corrections. Okay, so we already discussed the ancient forms of corrections or penal punishment, and of course we already discussed the Age of Enlightenment or the Reformation era, kung saan those time ay yung tao ay namulat sa katotohanan na ang barbaric punishment ay hindi talaga effective form of punishment, in the sense na wala silang basis at ito ay inhumane, ito ay nagbabiolate ng human rights. Kaya ngayon, nandito na tayo sa modern day of correction. Okay? So in this particular discussion, you will be able to know, you'll be able to understand, and of course, you will be able to discuss the modern day corrections. Okay, moving on. Modern penal management incorporates general principles of treating offenders that are based on humane practices such as the following. Okay? So, in modern penal management, you know what's penal management? It's about controlling, managing prisons and jails. Of course, we have the modern principles, how we treat offenders. Of course, it should be humanly, the treatment. It should not violate the rights of persons deprived of liberty. Okay. So we have number one, jail or prison rules shall be applied impartially without discrimination on ground of race, color, language, religion, or other opinion, national or social origin, property, birth, or other status. Okay, again, jail or prison rules. We're talking of rules. Dapat ay patas. Walang kinikilingan, walang discrimination. Kung ikaw man ay, kasi we're talking of our prison here in the Philippines, hindi lang Pilipino yung kinukulong, kahit sino pwedeng ikukulong. Kahit foreigner, kinukulong natin dito or initrate natin dito, kinukorek natin dito sa Pinas, as long as the person is under our territory and he or she committed a crime. So walang discrimination, even you are a foreigner, wala ding treatment, no? Walang treatment, walang color, language, religion, kahit anong language mo, it should be treated equally. Okay? So yan, that's the modern day correction. Di plus dati may discrimination. May discrimination yan. In fact, that's why Cesar Lombroso created his own theory of Lombrosian theory of what the so-called those ugly faces are called born criminal. Are you familiar with born criminal? Okay? Because ang kinukulong noong unang panahon ay during the medieval time in Europe, ang kinukulong nila yung mga pangit. That is why the result of the research of Dr. Cesar Lombroso ay napagtanto niya na yung mga criminal pala ay mga pangit, kaya sinabi niya, kaya na develop niya yung theory na burn criminal. Meaning so to say, bata ka pa lang ay pinanganak ka ng criminal. Paglaki mo, magiging criminal ka. And that's the born criminal. Okay? Because that time, may discrimination. Pag pangit ka, then pwede kang kulong nila. O, diba? This discrimination. And walang yung treatment din ay dinidiscriminate nila. Baga, may pinapaboran doon sa kulungan. So ngayon, walang pabor-pabor. Kahit anong language mo, anong race mo, anong religion mo, kahit ano pang opinion mo, walang pinapanigan dyan. Okay? Impartially. The second one, the religious belief and moral precepts not contrary to law which a prisoner holds must be respected. Okay, ano yun? So, if you have the religion in your, if you, whatever sector you are now, as long as it will not against the law, you know, it should be respected in jail and prisons. Okay, so all the jail personnel or the correction personnel, correction officers, all of those personnel inside the jail or prison shall respect your right to religion, your religion, your religious belief. It should be respected. Of course, pinagbabawalan natin yung mga religious beliefs that against the law. Okay? But if it is not against the law, lahat ng opinion ninyo about religions should be respected. Okay? Then we have also prison or jail rules and regulations shall be applied with firmness but tempered with understanding. Okay, so mga rules natin, regulations, firmness, mahinahon, at of course, with consideration. If the prisoner violates or break the rules, regulations, wag naman nating bigyan ng hatol agad, tanungin natin bakit niya nalabag yun. So ganun ang treatment. You should also be considerate if you are a correction officer or a jail officer to understand whatever the problems of the persons deprived of liberty. Hindi porke ay nag-violate siya, bigyan na natin ng parusa or punishment, whether it be physical or mental punishment. Okay, should be understand. So tanungin muna natin, no? Yung person deprived of liberty who break the law or rules or regulation inside the prison or jail. Tanungin natin, bakit mo nalabag itong ating rules or policy? So, ganun yan. So, dapat with utmost consideration. So, yan. Then, custodial force shall at all times conduct themselves as good examples. Okay? Good example, so in the prison, bawal mag-inom-inom doon, bawal yung party-party doon. So, dapat yung mga jail officer or correction personnel, shall at all times. So, lahat ng oras ay dapat hindi rin sila nag-violate sa kanilang policy, sa kanilang rules and regulations. At iwasan din nila yung mga vices para maging magandang ihimplo sila sa mga priso or persons deprived of liberty. Okay? Yan na. So, soon, as future correction officer, kayo mga correction officer kayo, jail officers, you should conduct at all times. As good examples. Okay? So, maging magandang halimbawa kayo sa inyong kliyente, the persons deprived of liberty. Okay? The fifth one, we have abusive or indecent language to prisoners shall not be used. Okay? So, mga abusive, yung mga lengguahe na pwedeng masaktan yung prisoner, hindi natin dapat ginagamit yan. Abusive. Alam nyo naman anong abusive or indecent language, no? Na pwedeng masaktan yung prisoner, pinagbabawal natin yan. Okay? O hindi natin dapat gamitin. Okay? Bawal natin insultuhin yung mga prisoners. Not to, hindi naman yan special treatment, but yung purpose kasi natin is to correct. Not to punish. Okay? Always put in mind that in the modern day corrections, our goal is to reform the persons deprived of liberty, not to punish him or her. Okay? So we are not in the medieval time. We are not in the ancient time. We are not in the age of enlightenment or the reformation era. We are now in the modern day corrections. And our goal is not to punish in the persons deprived of liberty, but rather to reform them. Okay? And of course, special care towards inmates shall be practiced, preventing humiliation or degradation. Hindi natin, bawal nating pinapahiya. Hindi natin dapat pinapahiya yung ating persons deprived of liberty. Okay? And we should prevent humiliation, not only to us as jail officer, but to the co-prisoners or co-PDL. So may mga PDL na minabastos or pinapahiya yung kapwa PDL nila. So tayo as jail officer, our job also is to prevent that humiliation to happen. Hindi natin kinukonsente yung mga PDL na nag-humiliate, nag-degrade ng ibang PDL. Okay? So we should treat them with special care. Special care. Tayo, pag tayo ay nagsasalita, bawal yung saywar. Bawal yung militaristic attitude. Okay? Dapat civilian at malumanay. Okay? Yan dapat ang ating personality as jail officer or correction officer. Hindi natin tinatakot. Hindi dapat natin tinatakot yung mga PDL. Noong una, as you can observe sa mga television, yung mga PDL tinatakot. Okay? Para sabi nila to establish superiority. Oh, okay, that's the in the modern day correction, bawal yan. Okay? Okay, so that our job is not to threaten but to encourage the persons deprived of liberty na magbago, na magbagong buhay. Okay? That's why death penalty is not really recommended by penologists and criminologists, simply because how can we correct the criminal if we will kill him? So we should not kill him, but to reform him. And we have also, no use of force must be made by any of the custodial force, except in self-defense or attempt to escape or in case of passive physical resistance to lawful order. Okay? So obviously, bawal yung force. Okay? Hindi tayo gamit ng dahas, ng physical force towards our clients, towards the PDL. Okay? Kahit pa siya ay talagang nagwawala, hindi dapat natin idaan sa physical or hindi natin dapat gamitin ang ating force. Hindi dapat natin gamitin yung barrel just to calm down the PDL. Okay? So for example, may mga riot. If kaya naman walang weapon, kaya naman psychological attack, then gawin natin. Okay, wag natin gamitin yung baril. Wag na natin gamitin yung weapon natin, yung physical weapon. Okay? Ang gamitin natin is what? What? Psychological attack. That is communication. Ba? Yan. Dapat you have good communication key skills. Okay? And of course, techniques, communication techniques. Okay? Then, of course, pag it will, if may nakikita kang tinatawag na imminent danger. Alam niyo what is imminent danger? Okay? May banta sa iyong sarili. Okay? Pag hindi ka gagamit ng physical force, eh, pwedeng mamatay ka. Okay? For example, may baril yung kalab, yung PDL. At alam mo na in a matter of seconds ay ipuputok yan sa iyo. Okay? That's the time that we can use force. Okay? Because that is under self-defense. Hindi na pag sila ay napatay natin under self-defense, hindi tayo makukulong. We are justified by law. Okay? Or the prisoner or the PDL attempt to escape from penal institution. So that's the time that we can use force. Other than that, we are not allowed to use of force. Okay? So yan. Okay, custodial force shall bear in mind that prisoners are sick people who need treatment. Sino sabi dyan? Si Sir Lombroso. Okay? We should not punish prisoners because they are sick people. Sila ay masakit, hindi pwede parusahan, kumbagkos, ay bigyan ng lunas ang kanilang sakit para sila ay gumaling. In that sense, ma-reform natin ang PDL. So that's our goal. Again, in a modern day correction, prisoners, criminals, we should not punish them, but again, to reform them. Baguhin natin ang kanilang buhay pag sila ay may criminal behavior na. Baguhin natin yan, gawin nating mabuting tao, yung PDL. Okay? Hey, that's all for now. Thank you very much for the listening.